What is going on? Charles Botensten here. We are again post-Thanksgiving. We are going into a new year. I don't care when you're watching this. It doesn't really matter. Habits are everything, okay? So obviously a lot of people, they go into the new year and they say, well, actually, this is the year. This is the year. I'm going to lose weight. I'm going to get a new job. I'm going to start the business. I'm going to get into a relationship. I'm going to get out of a relationship. It doesn't really matter. But they always say this is the year, or this is the month, or this is the day. You know, before I actually get into it, I would say that there is no right time. You know, there is no time that you're gonna say when I feel motivated. I waited 10 years until I felt motivated to do something. And that was to take care of areas of my life that I needed to. Health was 2017. This year it was business. Next year it's gonna be growing my team, which I'm in real estate. There is no right time. You're never going to feel motivated. You're never going to feel like it. Once I go through this, then you'll say, okay, it's going to be a little bit easier. The second thing is that I have to say, actually kind of the third thing, is Tony Robbins and Brian Tracy, they call it Someday Isle. Everyone is on Someday Isle. So that's an island where everyone goes and they say, someday I'll start talking to people. Someday I'll start making sales calls. Someday I'll take care of my health or my wealth, or start saving or paying down my debt, or I'll start actually putting money into my IRA, 401k. I'll do it someday. In other words, they live there. And one of the biggest things when you live there is that it's really hard to get off that island. It's really hard for two reasons. Number one is the people you surround yourself, which is something I'm going to be talking about. And the second thing is your habits become so ingrained in you that you just say, well, you know, this is just how it is. And then you start accepting that into your life. And the last thing I'll say with this is there was a study that came out, and every year, and actually leading up to the year, is that every gym membership, Equinox, you know, Crunch, Planet Fitness, wherever it is, they know that they have a select amount of time to just hammer home their deals, their new year deals, their no money down, no initiation fee, free months. And they say that if you don't, and this is why Equinox does it, is that you have a 1 year commitment, because they know if you do month to month, you're just gonna stop after 2 months or 1 month. But they actually came to a series of events and they said that it's around 17 days. 17 days is when most people pull the trigger or pull out of a gym and they stop going. But they said if you actually go for 17 days and beyond, you'll probably get that to become a habit, because in January, it's the hardest time. It's cold, it's snowing in the Northeast, no one's going to the gym, there's no body that you have to get ready for in the summer or the spring or weddings or things like that. So there's no incentive. Let's go into the book. Enough about that. I'm gonna break this down to two parts. These are the top things that I got out of this. Number one that he talks about, James Clear, by the way, I went all in on his podcast, his YouTube videos. Highly recommend listening to his interviews. Go to his website. His website has one of the best all-around articles, blogs that I've ever read in my life. Highly recommend you check that out. The guy is great, and he also talks about that he's not perfect. He's just like us. In other words, there's a lot of people that you see, like, say The Rock, and they're like, how is this guy wealthy? He's tall, he's handsome, he's jacked, he's making tons of money, he's famous and all those things. He also has insecurity. He also goes through doubt, but it's all about the habit. So number one is the 2 minute rule. You've probably heard of the 5 minute rule, the 5 second rule by Mel Robbins. Highly recommend that book. That's more about the initiation of getting out of bed when your alarm goes off, or putting on your shoes immediately. And what James talks about is that you focus on the first 2 minutes of a habit. So in other words, the habit of going to the gym is massive. You have to put on your shoes, your gym clothes, get into a car or subway, and then go to the gym. You have to work out, then you shower, then you put on your work clothes. That's an hour, hour and a half right there. But what James is talking about is focus on the first 2 minutes of it. You know, if you're making sales calls like I do every single morning, it is you focus on just picking up the headset, which I have right here, picking up the headset, and then you just start making calls. Don't think about the 15, 20, 30, 40 conversations that you're gonna have. Focus on the first 2 minutes. Who am I gonna call first? Ghostbusters. Couldn't help myself. Second thing, excuse me. Most think of the extreme they want to do in a system. Okay, so what he talks about is that most people say they want to become jacked or have a rippling six pack or make millions of dollars. And what he talks about is it's about honing in the system. The system is not to make 70 calls. The system is not to have rippling abs. Yeah, that will be a result. But he said, focus on the system. Okay, when I go to bed, I have my gym shoes right next to my bed. I have my gym clothes right next to my bed. It's not in your drawer. It's drawer, or however you say it. Your clothes are not scattered all over the place. For me, I put everything out the night before. I put out my work clothes, I put out my gym bag, I put out my gym clothes. So when I, and now it's cold, a jacket. So when I wake up, everything's there already. I'm not saying, what am I gonna wear, how, you know, either to the gym or to work, you know, suit and tie. That takes time. So when I wake up, I literally have nothing in my way to actually say no besides your mind. So that's why you focus on the 2-minute rule. Then you focus on the system. But the thing is, you can't actually hone the system if you don't start the habit. A lot of people, they go into the analysis paralysis, which I have right here, is that they think so far into the future, which goes into number two. They think so far into the future. I want to have a mega company. I want to be distributing my product and my service globally. But they don't focus on the first 2 minutes. They don't make it easy. And they have so much on their mind on where they want to go that they don't take action because they're saying, I need the best shoes. I need to do the best research on gym, on gyms, on what to do at the gym, on, say, sales calls. I got to have my objections handled. I got to have my script ready. You got to start before you start honing. Moving on. It's the repetition. I wrote this down a little bit further. It's not about the outcome. The outcome will come. Okay, it's all about repetition. So the best way to think about it is frequency over time. In other words, you have time, which is people say, how long does it take? Okay, no. It's about frequency. How often are you doing it? He said it's better to do one workout, or say one, the easiest way is a half an hour workout every single day, or a 5-minute workout every single day for 5 days, rather than Friday doing an hour. And the reason being is that if you go in no days of working out and then you expect to work out on a Friday or a weekend or a Saturday or a Sunday or eat healthy, that's not gonna happen. But if you're making it frequency, which he said, it doesn't matter about the length, that will come. It's all about the frequency of it. Moving on. When you build up the repetition, this is something that's very important, is that it's an identity that actually starts getting honed into you. So in other words, the identity of I am a runner, I'm a marathoner, I'm a writer, I make sales calls, I am the best agent, whatever the case is that your identity, you yourself get tied to what you're doing. You type 5 sentences, you don't think you're a writer. You go to the gym 4 or 5 times, you don't think you're a gym rat, or you're a marathoner, or you're a cyclist. You don't think that, or you're a networker, you go to one networking event. But he said over time is the biggest thing that you could do is actually make this part of your identity. Moving into that is a lot of people say, how long does it take? And he said, there is no time, this is a lifestyle. This is something that you just do forever. Because if you say, I'm doing it for a wedding, you know, I'm losing weight for a wedding, or I'm doing this to pay down my debt, and then you stop, that's not really a habit. That's just something that you do as a trend, that's more of a fad. So when it becomes part of your identity, you say, this is who I am. And for me is that if I don't go to the gym, I feel really weird. My sales calls aren't as good. My day isn't as good. I feel lethargic. It's totally different. This is actually a really good way to, especially when you're tired, you're hungover, you don't want to do it, you feel like you deserve a break or things like this. This is the best way. Instead of saying, I have to, he says, I get to. I have to go to the gym. I have to go to this networking event. I have to make sales calls. I have to start a business. He says, no. I get to go to the gym. I get to make sales calls. I get to help people out. Whatever the case is, I get to. And then this is the last thing is, tie a habit into something you're already doing. Perfect example, when I wake up in the morning, I'm already putting my gym clothes into my bag to go to the gym. During that time, I'm also listening to great motivational talks or an audiobook, whatever the case is that you're already tying something you're doing. So if you're brushing your teeth, put in an audiobook. When you're commuting, put in an audiobook. He said also when you're doing something else, say you're making sales calls and you need to do something beforehand, say get ready for the sales calls, or you need to do something, you tie in when I do this, then I do this. His example was that he didn't floss that often. So he said, well, the reason I didn't floss too often is because the floss was underneath the sink, and then I would have to go down, bend down, get the floss, pull it out, start flossing. So he said what he did was anytime he put his floss right up on his sink, and he said anytime he brushed his teeth, the floss was right there, boom. So he removed all the tough things that were in the way, which was bending down, going in there. He didn't see it, he didn't like it, he didn't like flossing, but he tied in brushing his teeth with flossing. That's so easy, but there's a lot of things that we're doing we could just tie in, you know, say this. You know, I come to work, I fill up my water bottle, and boom, that's it. I don't come to work and then start making my sales calls. I'm like, ooh, I'm thirsty right now. No. I come to work, I'm tying in my sales calls with this. So I get this, then I tie in with my sales calls, drink at least a gallon a day, minimum, flushes out a lot of things. And it also just feels a lot better than anything else, coffee, tea, things like that. So this is part one. Part two, we have a lot more in-depth kind of practical steps that can make you guys build better habits. Honestly, for me, the easiest thing is just start one, which is going to the gym. When you start going to the gym consistently, that kind of bleeds into something else. For me, it was going to the gym, and then there was someone at Whole Foods that was pretty, went up to her, started talking, exchanged contact information. I wouldn't have never actually probably had the gall or the audacity, or, you know, I kind of, now it's my identity that if I see someone that I want to talk to, whether it's someone famous or someone I want to network with or a pretty girl that I want to go on a date with, it's part of my identity now. But if I did not go to the gym, I'm it's just, you know, you say no to one thing, you're probably gonna say no to something else. But if you say yes to the gym, you kick ass at the workout, and then you're at Whole Foods, you're already in a better mood, you're tying in habits. Then you come to work, then you're excited, you went to the gym, you approached this pretty girl, exchange contact information, why not make sales calls? You make sales calls, then you go, and then you just start eating salad, and then you go in, you all combines. Highly recommend you pick up. This is probably one of the best books I've ever read. Link is below. It's affiliated, I think it is. So if you want, you can give me a couple of pennies. If not, I don't really care, but go out and buy the book. It is the best, and I've read Power of Habit by Charles Duhigg. I've read Mini Habits, which is another great book. There's just, he just combines a lot, all right? So we'll go into part two tomorrow. Have an amazing day. Talk to you guys soon.